with over 12 million Kenyans on WhatsApp, I'm gonna take a guess that you are in each one of these five WhatsApp groups. We all are. My name is Mark Kaigwa and you're watching Digital Africa. Firstly, if you haven't seen my video on using WhatsApp for business, you want to click either in the description or across this video to see that one and start there. And if you've already seen that and you haven't seen the social media statistics video, you'll probably want to see that one as well. Now we're gonna get to it, and you've been wondering, but yes, here are the five WhatsApp groups. We are all in. You don't even get to choose. You're not even the admin in some cases. You are added, but whatever the case, these are the five WhatsApp groups we are all in. Number five, your family. Yes, cousins, uncles and aunties, if you're married, different sides of the family, extended family, nuclear family, family. You're in a family WhatsApp group. Admit it. You know it's true. Number four, remember your cap and gown? Masters, high school. Some of you actually graduated high school. Others finished and cleared. Some haven't been back for their clearance certificates. I'm not gonna get into the details, but you're likely in a university or a high school or even executive education, wherever you got your education from. You're likely in a school-related WhatsApp group. You might not even have contributed anything for the last 6 months, but you're there anyway. At number three is your workplace or office WhatsApp group. Please leave a comment and a thumbs up or a like below this video if you want me to do a special video on WhatsApp in the workplace. Let me know. I have some great ideas for that, because some of you are struggling and others of you are rejoicing. But ultimately, it is almost the future of instant messaging and communication in the workplace, but it does need some ground rules. Long story short, your boss, you, your supervisors, maybe you've never said a word because it's just for read only, but you do have a work or office WhatsApp group. Number two is your neighborhood or apartment complex or whatever housing arrangement you're in, housemates. It's likely that there's a WhatsApp group for that. The keys are under the mat. The gate's gonna be locked at this time. So and so, you've parked in my spots. Your lights are on, KBX something something. Whoever it is, you are likely in a group like this. And it's probably because you don't know your neighbors all that well. So Nyumba Kumi, or the 10 houses, 10 homes, 10 neighbors initiative in Kenya. This is probably an example of that. So you're probably in one with your neighbors. And at number one is leisure groups. So it could be your exercise and gym workout buddies. It could be your drinking buddies. It could be your girlfriends. It could be political leanings. But ultimately, they're probably leisure and interest groups that are also part of your WhatsApp. And that's probably, in some cases, the volume of the different groups that you're in. You were on a road trip one time, somebody set up a WhatsApp group, all of you are afraid to leave, and it's been silent for years. Oh, that's me. Anyway, you're in a leisure group of some kind, and that's probably the volume, outside of the others, of the groups that you're in. And your bonus tip of this video is either your chama, if you're from Kenya, so that is a savings group or a slash social group, so social and savings. Sometimes they're a bit more serious, sometimes they're not. And you could also have a religious group. So whatever your denomination or religious leanings or beliefs, you are likely or potentially gonna have different, it could be cell groups, it could be regions for Bible study or whatever the case may be, you're likely going to have several types of groups like that. Some of you will even have groups for your company or your team and a client where you're having business interactions. So that's another bonus tip on this different kind of set of groups that could also be part of the five. So if you don't find that you're in all five above, you're definitely in one of these ones. hit the like button if you have sent a leisure message into a work group. If you do it the other way around, it really doesn't matter because you actually look serious, like you actually work on WhatsApp. That's some of you. Anyway, hit the thumbs up and the like button if that's you. And if you don't know already, this might be a really important message to you. WhatsApp now has a delete function. Two things, it needs to be within the first 7 minutes of when you've sent the message. And secondly, when you press and hold that particular message, it depends on whether you are on Android or iOS or Apple. But depending on the case, we'll share a link here on how to delete a WhatsApp message. You can, and you are recommended to, not just delete it for yourself, but delete it for everyone. So it'll save you a couple embarrassing moments in a couple groups. Thank me later. Thanks for watching. What kind of WhatsApp questions do you have? If you haven't seen our video on WhatsApp for Business, we got some great questions there and interacted with a number of you in the comments. If you're yet to subscribe to the channel, you can get videos like this first. And you could do that by just clicking subscribe. It's free, no cost to you, and you will be the first to know. If you want to join 1,700 other readers and leaders who are part of our Letter N newsletter community, you can also subscribe in the description below. And lastly, tell a friend, share, comment, like the video, and I'd love to hear from you. So sound off in the comments or on social media. You'll see all of our handles. And my name is Kaigwa. You're watching Digital Africa.